Thank you.
Thank you, Ciarán Comhairle. Taoiseach, on November the 12th last, I raised with you allegations made by a whistleblower from within the ranks of the senior civil service. The whistleblower in question was the authorised officer appointed to examine a scheme of tax evasion through Ansbacher accounts. The whistleblower has come forward with allegations of tax evasion by senior political figures and obstruction in the investigation and exposure of these wrongdoings. The whistleblower says that his investigation into Ansbacher accounts, offshore accounts and tax evasion was terminated by then Minister Mary Harney in 2004, once Mr Desmond O'Malley was discovered to be one of the holders of these accounts.
You can't be making allegations like that, please. You cannot make allegations of that nature in the chamber.
The whistleblower further alleges that other senior figures from Fianna Fáil and Fine Gael also held these very secret Ansbacher accounts that were administered by the late Des Traynor and a Mr Padraig Collery, formerly of Guinness and Mahon. The whistleblower reports, as I have said, absolute obstruction to his efforts to complete his investigation. He further reports that agencies of the state have failed to investigate all of these matters thoroughly, including tribunals of inquiry. Now, on the 12th of November, Taoiseach, you directed me to the Public Accounts Committee. You said that that was the proper place to have these matters investigated. The Public Accounts Committee has been advised last night that we will not be permitted to investigate these matters, neither issues around alleged tax evasion, nor indeed allegations of political obstruction or even indeed corruption.
Question, please.
So can I ask you now, Taoiseach, what next? Can the serving civil servant complete his investigation? I know that he has made that request of Minister Richard Bruton. Will he permit that? Will you permit that? What of any Garda investigation? I know that Minister Bruton very belatedly passed on a witness statement to the Garda Bureau for Fraud investigation. Will you be in contact with the Commissioner to ask about progress in that case and any possible arrests or prosecutions? You sent me in the direction of the Public Accounts Committee, Taoiseach. These very, very serious matters will not be heard or investigated there. So what do you propose as an alternative action?
Well, the Public Accounts Committee did receive legal advice from the Oireachtas that you mentioned yesterday evening. I think the position has already been outlined by the Minister for Jobs and Enterprise in pointing out that all of the issues that were raised by the whistleblower, which by the way came about as a welcome change and reform here by the government in terms of allowing for protection of witnesses' disclosures in matters like this. And obviously the delay was pointed out by the Minister, who has since sent on the documentation that is required and was requested by the Garda Fraud Investigation Unit. It's not for me to contact the Commissioner of the Garda about the documentation received by the Fraud Investigation Committee. They know exactly what their powers are, and obviously will act upon the witness statement sent to them. The question of the charges that you make against certain people are not for me to answer here. There's a process that is now under train, and that is now in train, that was availed of under the legislation by the whistleblower, and the documentation required and requested by the Fraud Investigation Committee in the Gardaí has been forwarded to them by the Minister, and obviously they will make their decisions and follow through on that. The Public Accounts Committee, of which you remember, did receive its own legal advice from the Oireachtas yesterday in respect of their powers.
Deputy MacDonald.
Well, Taoiseach, it's not a case of me making allegations against anyone, and I emphasise these are allegations, but they come from a very credible source. And the whistleblower alleges Des O'Malley, Ray McSharry, Jared Collins, Maura Gagan-Quinn, and S. Barrett, Richie Ryan, a former Minister for Finance, and others.
Sorry.
And the.
Are you making these allegations here in the chamber?
Pardon me?
Did you make allegations here in the chamber regarding.
I am echoing the allegations that are very serious that have been brought forward by the whistleblower. That is the allegation, Account Coroner.
No, that you know quite clearly, if you bother to check the records and take advice from the clerk at the door, you cannot name names of people who are defenceless. To contradict you.
Well, Karen Corlett.
So there's a long established principle in this chamber. I know you're in you and the dog, but I'd ask you to brief yourself clearly on what you can and cannot do in a democratically elected chamber.
The difficulty, Taoiseach, is this.
And I wish to state quite categorically, in case anybody is under any doubts when you say S. Barrett, it doesn't apply to me.
Thank you, Karen Corlett. Taoiseach, the difficulty is this. The whistleblower alleges matters of serious concern associated with very senior public figures, some of whom are still in receipt of state payments by way of pension as we speak. The whistleblower has told us very clearly that he has gone to every length to have these matters explored and investigated. And the whistleblower now fears that will never happen.
Put your question,
now,
please. Thank
my
you.
Question is this. Given the serious nature of these allegations against named persons and perhaps the more serious allegation that there was a connivance to avoid or even to cover up the exposure of these matters, and given the fact that the Public Accounts Committee is not permitted to investigate these matters, what, Taoiseach, do you propose to do? Because they are very serious allegations. So, will Richard Bruton allow the person in question to complete their investigation?
Thank you.
That's one option. Or will you, as Taoiseach, and will the government, given the seriousness of these allegations, propose another mechanism for the full examination of these issues, for the full examination of agencies of the state, who...
You're over time, Deputy. Would you please adhere to the chair? Thank you.
...these matters fully and thoroughly.
Taoiseach.
The law was introduced here for whistleblowers to bring forward certain matters of information that they feel are relevant and important in the public interest. And the law is framed to protect the whistleblower, and that's an important reform, and that's a central element of the law, and that must be maintained. The whistleblower must be protected. Now, the Fraud Squad Investigation Unit made a formal request for a witness statement to be forwarded to them by the Minister for Jobs and Enterprise. The Deputy is well aware of the reasons why that was delayed. Minister Bruton pointed out why that was delayed. Minister Bruton confirmed that the witness statement, as requested, has been forwarded to the Fraud Squad Investigation Bureau. That's an arm of the state with particular and specific responsibilities and powers. And I would expect that the Fraud Investigation Unit will follow through and act upon the witness statement that has been forwarded to them. Clearly, the advice given to the Public Accounts Committee is that this is outside their remit, and that's formal legal advice, I'm sure, to them. I haven't seen that advice or read it. You're a member of that committee yourself. So the opportunity now exists in the process of the law here for the Fraud Investigation Unit to act upon the witness statement forwarded by the whistleblower and sent through the Minister for Jobs and Enterprise to them for their examination. This is not some kind of opportunity to send it away on a journey from where it will never come back. This is a formal request from the Fraud Investigation Unit that has been now acted upon. The witness has forwarded his statement, and that's been sent to them.
Thank you.
And confirmed that. In fact, I know that the whistleblower had that confirmed to him last week by the Minister. So I expect the Fraud Unit to investigate.
Deputy Maureen O'Sullivan.